Most associate Nintendo games with the greats, like Super Mario Brothers and Super Smash Brothers and Legend of Zelda. But with all the great games and the Nintendo lineup, Nintendo has definitely released some duds in their time as a company. What is up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos, welcome to Chaos Top 10s. And today, we're going to be going over the top 10 worst Nintendo games ever made. To be eligible for this list, a game must have been released for a Nintendo console or been published by Nintendo with the official Nintendo seal of approval on the box art or the cartridge. That makes them an official Nintendo game. So sit back, drop a like on the video. In the comment section, of course, you let us know where we get it right and wrong and which ones we missed, and away we go. At number 10, we have Friday the 13th. Kicking off this list is an atrocious survival horror title for the NES. We're going all the way back to the classic 8-bit NES. Is this game even survival horror? I'm not actually sure what to call the game. It's just bad. We'll call it bad. You play as a group of camp counselors trying to defend their camp from Jason. The graphics are bad, the music and sound effects are super annoying, and Jason looks stupid as hell, which is hard to do because Jason's cool. Jason's a cool horror character, and is also way too difficult when you fight him in the dumb punch-out style boss fights. Maybe that's the point, since he's pretty unkillable in the movies, but it's no excuse for a game being this bad. Okay, at number 9, we are going to break our rules already. Bible Adventures. And we're technically breaking our own rule by putting this game on the list because it didn't actually get the Nintendo seal of approval. But it's way too bad to not include in this top 10, so we're putting it down at number 9. Plus, it's not every day that you get a game of the Bible. I bet most of you didn't even know there was a biblical video game out there. So what do you do in this classic NES game? It's a side-scrolling Super Mario Bros. 2 clone that had the player reliving the events of David and Goliath, Noah's Ark, and yes, baby Moses with tons of scripture readings in between the levels. Aside from being poorly programmed, the game was heavily criticized for repeating levels and being an obvious copy of Super Mario Bros. 2, which had been released a couple years prior. Needless to say, it earned its spot on this list. Hotel Mario garners our number 8 spot today, widely regarded as the worst Mario game ever. This dud came out in 1994 for the Philips CD-i. It was a puzzle game in which Mario had to go through a series of hotels in order to, you guessed it, save Princess Toadstool. The controls were super unresponsive, the graphics and the animations were gross, and the gameplay was insanely repetitive. You basically just go around and close doors, and that's it. It's a video game where you go around closing doors. It seems pretty much like no Philips Nintendo game was ever good. Someone somewhere decided to release a bunch of simplistic games with fully animated cutscenes. That was their hook to try to get people in. Hotel Mario, Zelda Wand of Gamelion, which we'll get into later. Whoever's idea it was to make these Nintendo games for the Philips CD-i, you should have, hopefully you got fired, honestly. I hope you don't work in the gaming industry at all anymore. Can't be a worst NES list without a Barbie game. This 1991 NES game was just called Barbie. It was made as an attempt to get more girls to play video games at the time. Well, it probably didn't succeed, because what the girls of the early 90s got was one of the worst NES games ever created. This was actually a 2D platformer where Barbie is living through her dreams and avoiding the Z's from falling on her and making you restart the game. The game didn't really interest anyone at the time it was released, and it really doesn't interest anyone nowadays either. It was just so painfully average, nothing original, nothing exciting, and nothing really drawing you to it. Everything you can do in Barbie can be done in better games, leading to this game getting completely forgotten, and for good reason. It's just lame, boring, repetitive, and lame. Next up, we have a classic, Super Pitfall. I remember Pitfall for the Atari. And this piece of garbage came from 1986, and this game is actually a remake of Pitfall 2 for the Atari, except for way, way worse. Released on the NES in 1986 in Japan, and then it came over to North America in 1987. It was a platform all about discovering diamonds and artifacts in caverns. Pretty cool, right? Indiana Jones-esque, right? Kind of like the video game version of the opening of the Raiders of the Lost Ark. However, as you may have guessed, It was horrible, or it wouldn't be on this list. The NES version was the worst of them all, with Computer Gaming World magazine citing it as a Super Mario Brothers rehash that most NES users will be able to play in their sleep. Certainly, there is nothing in the game itself to keep them awake. The main problem was that it was trying to be an early example of a sandbox game while still being a platformer, leading to the game being super open and boring with incredibly vague instructions that were supposed to encourage exploration. But really all it did was just serve to annoy you with trial and error. Not many Donkey Kong games will make it on this list, but Donkey Kong Jr. Math has made it in our number 5 spot. Since the beginning of video games, there has always been companies trying to make their games educational so parents will buy them for their kids. After all, if you're a parent, would you rather your kid play Mario Brothers or some spelling game that would teach them how to do better in school? Well, here we have Donkey Kong Jr. Math, one of the earliest examples of those awful educational games. Released in 1983 in Japan and in 1986 in North America for the NES, this game tried to be a middle ground between platforming and math class and required the player to climb vines to collect numbers to answer the math questions. So exciting, right? Well, as you can probably expect, no one really cared about this game, and it was a huge commercial flop as well as a critical disaster, as pretty much everyone hated it. With lame graphics and animations, boring gameplay, and way too easy of math questions, this game thankfully managed to cancel the educational Nintendo games that were planned at the time. At least something came good out of Donkey Kong Jr. Math. Okay, this is a love-hate right here. Some of you may remember this and you may love it. Number 4 is Shaq Fu. Okay, it's one of those games that's so bad that it's good, but you have to admit that the game is really, really bad. Who thought a Shaq video game would ever be good? Probably the same people that came up with Michael Jackson Moonwalker. Anyway, Shaq Fu came out in 1994 for the Sega Genesis and the Super NES and was met with pretty mixed reviews. On one hand, you had people saying it was awesome and the graphics were nice, which they were, they're okay. And then on the other hand, you had people saying it was stupid, repetitive, and bad, which it also was. Either way, Shaq Fu has gone down in gaming history as one of the weirdest and one of the worst games of all time. At number 3, we have Where's Waldo? Yep, there was a Where's Waldo game for the NES. Released in 1991, this game was actually developed by Bethesda. That's right, Bethesda. The Skyrim and Fallout and Doom Bethesda. Well, I guess everyone starts somewhere. The player was supposed to help Waldo get to the moon by finding him in each of the 8 levels, because that's how space exploration works, apparently. The game was hammered by critics and gamers, mainly because the graphics were so bad that it was almost impossible to find Waldo in many of the levels. The game deliberately put objects in the levels that looked like Waldo, much like the books did, but the graphics were so muddy that everything just blended together. Plus, Waldo would sometimes change color without warning. I think the game was an ultimate troll, making him even more impossible to find because you didn't even know what you were looking for. Thank goodness Bethesda got their act together a few years later to give us some of the greatest games of all time. Despite being so horrible, the next year there was actually a sequel released for the Super NES, The Great Waldo Search, and that sequel was remade in 2009 for the Wii as Where's Waldo, The Great Journey. I guess Waldo knows something we don't about video games, because apparently he's had a lot of them. It pains me to put this on the list, but I have to do it. Zelda Wand of Gamelin, I don't even know how to say it. At number 2, I don't know whose idea it was for Nintendo to take their epic story-driven series, one of the best video game series of all time, The Legend of Zelda, and turn it into a cheesy, cringe-worthy Saturday morning cartoon-style game. But it was a horrible idea, with really uncomfortable visuals, terrible writing, and some of the most annoying voiceover actor work I've ever seen. The Wand of Gamelin was released for the Philips CD-i. Lo and behold, everything for the Philips CD-i sucked. And believe it or not, the game was actually praised when it was released for incorporating beautiful animation and having a wonderful storyline. No, really. That's what people said about the game when it came out. Thankfully, the game was revisited in recent years and has been reevaluated to be considered one of the worst games of all time. Thank goodness. I don't think I could sleep at night knowing that people actually like this game, even though it's tied to one of my favorite video game franchises of all time. This is a no-brainer for me at number 1. You saw this coming. Superman 64. The game is horrible. Released for the Nintendo 64 in 1999, the game was intended to tie in with Superman, the animated series, which was running at the same time. Because of insane time constraints, tons of corners were cut during development, and the game was released famously unfinished and buggy as hell. Aside from the bugs, the game looks awful with crazily outdated graphics, repetitive gameplay, a dumb story, and insanely difficult controls, even when it's not glitching out on you. Superman 64 has gone down in history as one of the worst games of all time, and for good reason. If you haven't played it, you probably should at least once, just as a history lesson so you never forget. Trust me, you probably won't ever play it again. And there you have it, my friends. Those are 10 of the worst Nintendo games ever made. Drop a like on the video. Check out the playlist below with all of the other video game top 10s that are up. And if you want to see anything specific, let me know in the comment section. I hope you guys have a great day. We'll be back tomorrow with another video.